Hello, welcome to Talk of the Town on Time, right?
And I'm Mo McNeary. Happy May.
Yes, happy May. Happy May month.
The month of May, yes. So I got to tell you first, met some more of your fans.
Oh, you did?
When I was out and about. Yes, I was at the Presbyterian Church. I had the honor of singing at a funeral there. Oh. And the church ladies that made the lunch love you.
Aw.
Big fans.
Was there Verna Dream? Was she in that crowd by chance? I'm still looking for you, Verna, if you're out there. Was she in that crowd?
No, but yeah. And I mean, it's just great news when you think of they could be watching the wheel. And
they could be watching the wheel, but they don't.
Tuned us in. It's all good. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes, so what else?
Well, what else is, you're looking at what else, right on top of here. Because
you got a new hairdo?
I got a hairdo.
You know, I noticed.
Guess who did the hairdo?
I wasn't sure because it's a windy day today, so I wasn't sure if that was what was
No, that's my artistic craft right there.
Are
that's
products involved?
Yeah, there's a little bit of product involved.
Who did your hair?
Yours truly. Yeah. Well, I was supposed to get a haircut this weekend. I had the kids. And I'm like, I got to have a haircut for the show.
Oh.
So I have got my kit because I cut my son's
show
hair.
Show us. I would love to see your beauty kit.
Yeah,
really? It fits
nice.
In that. You should
this
see
is
my
cordless, folks.
My
I should,
beauty.
You know, I'm going to cover up. Well, wait. Because I'm going to send the bill if I show it.
My beauty kit is a suitcase, but you could fit yours.
But I wanted to show you proof, too. I have a couple of pictures of here.
Okay. I don't even know what we're looking at. What? That is gross. You cut your own hair?
Yeah. Swipe it. There's a good close-up in there.
There's a...
That's the important
gross.
Part.
Gross.
Yeah.
who cleaned this up for you? Don't let that go down the drain. Or you'd be calling the... Oh, your kids, too.
Yep.
Wow. I should
have made them clean up.
So you cut your own hair?
I did, yeah. Because I was a barracks barber back in the day, back in the Army day.
Okay, stop. What?
Yeah.
You did what?
I cut the hair in the barracks. Because we had to have a haircut every week. Is the high and tight.
Did you get some dough for that?
The high and tight haircut that drove all the ladies crazy, I'm sure. The shaved sides of the head.
Yes.
You know, the mohawk looking haircut that I absolutely hated.
I didn't know you did that.
Oh, yeah.
Huh.
So, yeah, a lot of us, we'd to save money, you just cut the hair. Somebody had a set of clippers in the barracks, and you'd cut hair every Sunday night.
I thought, why Sundays? That should be your day of rest.
Well, in the Army, it's the day of haircuts. That's what it is. Yeah.
That is crazy.
Yeah.
Wow. Well, I'm very impressed. It looks really nice.
Yeah, I was going to say, if you see anything, we might have to do some cleaning up after the show.
You know what? Congratulations. That's awesome.
Thank you. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Well, in the month of May, Mo, as you know, it is a special holiday called Mother's
Cinco
Day.
Cinco de Mayo. Oh.
No, Mother's Day. Get with it. How rude to your own mom. That's probably watching this right now.
I'm a mother, too. Mother.
Yeah, yeah.
I love Mother's Day. I got to tell you, it's a beautiful, I'm finally a mother, you know, and when you become a mother in your 40s, you don't take it for granted. Yes. No, you don't. You realize how great it is.
Yes.
And how it's a blessing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I must say you're a great mom here on set too, that you help you bring us treats here all the time. She's such a great mommy on set too. You are.
That's so nice.
Yes.
Well, I need to look out for you youngsters.
Keep us in line.
Anyway, so getting back to Mother's Day, yes. And so we went out snooping around, didn't we?
We did. We went out to, yes, a great restaurant called Perkins here in town to mm-hmm. talk about mothers. So let's see what we found out. All right, we're here at Perkins. I'm with Chris Kennedy, the general manager at Perkins, the top dog. The top dog here, Chris.
I guess so.
I know, it's a hot spot here. I hear you guys like do the most business for Perkins in the Twin Cities metro area. Is that right?
not at all. We got Roseville and Apple Valley way ahead of us, so.
Like per capita, though?
I don't know.
Chris, just roll with it.
Man, you're
this is the highest grossing Perkins here in the Twin Cities area. That's news.
At least in Hastings.
At least in Hastings. Chris, you look like a guy that has a good mom, is good to your mom. We're here for Mother's Day talking about moms. So tell us about your mom. Would she be the type that would take care of Perkins just like you?
Oh, my mom is great. She is down at the River of Life, and she always is talking us up and trying to bring more business in for me and always there for anything I need.
Happy Mother's Day to all of you, and tell us about your own mother.
My mother, she is from La Crosse, Wisconsin, and she is probably the most amazing mother ever.
And happy Mother's Day to you. How many kids do you have?
I have three.
I love it.
Two girls and a boy. And second grandbaby coming. There is our first, so.
And what would be your favorite way to spend Mother's Day if you had if you had the perfect day in mind?
Perfect day would be spend time with your mother.
All right, here with another great table at Perkins and talking about Mother's Day. And you are a mom?
Yes, I am.
And how many kids?
Three.
Three, all right. Now, I know we're not supposed to pick our favorites, but really, who is your favorite?
There's none. They're all equal.
They're all equal. Sure, sure.
And we are going to interrupt this table. I did a little pre-interviewing. Oh my gosh, wait until you hear this story. This is Robin and Robin's mother. And Robin, tell us who these two gentlemen are with you.
This is my son Daniel, he's 12. And this is Peyton, he's 11, and he is being adopted today. So we're having a breakfast before we go to court to make it final.
Peyton, congratulations to you, honey. Today is the day. How exciting.
It's really exciting to, yeah.
Tell us this story.
We're foster parents, and Peyton has lived with us for a few years, and he needed a forever family, and he's our third son we've adopted because kids need a permanent place and be loved, and today is the day.
And Grandma, tell us about you. You're in town for this.
I'm from Colorado, and I came in for this special occasion today, but I wouldn't miss it for anything. My new grandson.
And Daniel, you can't be silent over there. What do you think? You have a great new celebration because you have a new brother.
Well, it just felt like he's been my brother all along. Now it's just official.
Will you adopt me? This is like the world's best family.
Tell us about your mom here. What kind of mom is she?
Fabulous. She's always been there, and she's raised three great kids, and we've turned out really well. And she, for example, she's going to be 79 years old, just drove a friend up to St. Cloud yesterday. And
wow. Yes. And obeyed all traffic laws, yes. Didn't get pulled over?
Yes. Definitely.
Okay. Wow, that's impressive. If she weren't here, what would you really say about her?
You know, probably the same stuff.
Sure. What do you think about being a mom?
Love it. It's the best job in the world. Well, it's not a job, really. It's a pleasure.
Tell us about your mom. What kind of mom you got?
I have a great mom. I'm a single parent of an 8-year-old boy.
Ah.
And she helps babysit a lot so that I can be here and serve my guests and everything. And I actually pay her in Perkins Bakery, believe it or not.
So. Tell us about being a mom yourself. 8-year-old, you said?
Yes. My son Kyle is 8 years old. I was born and raised in Hastings, and he's energetic and jumpy, and any little boy, my little monkey. So I just love him to pieces.
You three look like you really know how to treat the ladies. Yeah. Oh, yes. Tell us all about it.
We know how to treat the ladies. Yes, we do.
And what?
Mother's Day.
On Mother's Day. What about the rest of the 364 days?
Yes, I know how to treat my wife very well.
What else can you say? How is she as a mother?
She's wonderful. She's like no other person I know of. She's the best mother I know.
And what about your own mom? What are some of the memories of your own mom?
My mother was great. My mother was a good person. She's cared for us as kids. She was a great mother. Great mother.
And how about you, sir? Tell us. Now, you also know how to treat the ladies?
Well, yes.
Pardon me, but everyone is laughing at your table.
No, my wife is very good. Very good to the grandkids. That's what she does mostly, is take care of the grandkids and
so you have more time to go to coffee.
That's right, and golf and stuff like that.
Okay, Bessie.
Yes?
I saw something here that really spoke to me. I really wanted to commemorate our friendship. And look right here.
Oh my gosh.
I mean, can you really? Does it get any more serious than this?
Oh my gosh. This is so nice. Thank you so much.
Goes with anything.
I think we're serious. And it will go with everything.
There you go.
Oh, what a great time at Perkins.
It was.
What a great stories there. And look at what I'm wearing.
I saw that.
My bracelet. Thank you very much. My friendship bracelet.
Yes.
So I will treasure it.
You should. It's 16 thread from Indonesia.
So 24
I don't thread. Give those to just anybody, Mo.
Thank goodness.
Yeah.
Though I see some people on set wearing them.
Oh,
anyway.
They're not 16 thread, I'm
telling
you.
Exactly. So we have a great show coming up.
We do. Cindy Theory Smith, the curator at the Hastings Pioneer Room. So she is the historian of historians in town. We're excited to meet her and to ask all the questions about history and all that fun stuff.
Exactly. And the month of May brings many kinds of celebrations, and one of them you will learn about in What a Crock.
Yes, can't wait. And welcome right back to Talk of the Town.
And we're so excited because our guest today is Cindy Thurie-Smith, and she is the curator of the Pioneer Room in Hastings. Mm-hmm. Welcome to you.
Thank you for inviting me.
Well, I'm so glad that you're here. Cindy, this area is full of history.
Colorful history, too.
Very colorful.
Fun history.
And that's what the Pioneer Room is all about, right?
It's just yep.
History, kind of like the official Hastings Archives or Museum,
yep,
maybe?
It's specifically about Hastings and a little bit on, you know, Nininger and New Trier and Meesville, the surrounding area, but pretty much we're specialized on Hastings history.
And for people that don't know where it's located, tell us where it is, please.
We're located on the first floor of the what used to be the Dakota County Courthouse, but it's now City Hall, on 4th Street. As you come in the door, the receptionist desk is right in front of you, and we are the first door off on the right.
Very cool. And you've been doing that volunteering, by the way, and doing it for over 16 years now?
14 years.
14 years.
Yep.
You can go with 16. It's 14 years.
Yep.
And tell us about, you mentioned that there is a lot of history in there. Are you from Hastings?
I'm not. Okay. I'm actually from up the road in St. Paul Park.
Okay. Well, and they let you touch the stuff in Hastings
yes,
City
yes,
Hall?
Yes, yes, yes.
How did you get interested in the history of Hastings?
Well, when my husband and I moved here in 1985, I thought it was such an interesting, cute little town. And I did start getting interested in the history of the river town. Mm-hmm. You know, Hastings is a good example of a river town. And then in 2002, when they advertised for it, I remember I was reading the want ads at breakfast with Kevin, and I said to him, well, this is a really strange job. They have really odd requirements. They want somebody who's done library work, and they want somebody who's done work with photographs and work with textiles. I said, where are they going to find anybody that's got qualifications like that? And he said, well, you've done all those. So I thought, oh, okay. So I applied, and I thought, it's a very interesting job. And it has been very interesting.
Wow.
Tell us about the range of things that you've come across in that Pioneer Room. From what to what have you seen?
Oh, gosh. We've got quilts that are 100 years old and are just beautiful and very delicate. And then we've got this 175-pound cast iron clamp down, which is... It's got a big kind of disc on the bottom and then a big hand-forged stem on the top with an opening, and you bury it in the ground and you clamp cables to it, and it holds up masonry walls, or it holds up... We're not sure if it was holding up part of the spiral bridge or part of the masonry building that was next to it, but they were buried in the ground. And the darn thing is so heavy, we can hardly move it around.
So do you rely on people to give you
yes,
artifacts
very
and,
much so.
And share the history?
Yep.
And who is the typical person that comes into the Pioneer Room?
It's kind of funny because it's usually somebody who's cleaning out a relative's home or a garage or something like that, and they come across these old things and they think it's kind of interesting, but they don't really want to throw it away. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And so they bring it in to see if we can use it in the Pioneer Room.
What's the strangest thing that you've received that was dropped off?
What a great question for you.
I can't imagine why, but one lady dropped off her great aunt's trousseau from the 1880s. It was this wonderful couple of nice suits and a wedding gown, and then we had this tie down dropped off to us, and we just had an original Edison light bulb given to us last week.
Wow.
Yeah. So those are kind of fun things.
Those are cool things.
Yeah. Very cool.
Wow. And tell us what you've learned about the history of Hastings. Share some of the things. We're the second oldest city in Minnesota.
Mm-hmm.
And so with that comes so much history.
Well, we were kind of a point from which you went elsewhere. You would come up the river on the boats, and Hastings was the highest point that they could get to every year, irregardless of what the weather was. So if it was a bad winter, or if it was a warm winter, you could come up to Hastings, unload, and you could go overland to St. Paul. Mm-hmm. So we had a lot of people that came up the river and got off in Hastings, and then they went elsewhere in the state to settle. And so we had a lot of people coming through.
Well, we got some great river town. Tot, 5 questions for you.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Okay.
We're going to set the mood here. Here you go.
Uh-oh.
It's getting serious. All right. First question. If we had a time machine here that you could hop in right now, would you travel forward or backward?
I would go backward a little bit.
A little bit?
A little bit. I don't want to go back to the cholera every year and no flushies and no refrigeration.
No flushies.
I need the flushies.
I need the refrigeration.
Good answer. That's a great answer.
Oh, my stars. If you were to write an autobiography in a book about your history, what would be the title?
Hula, square dancing, and belly dancing. And Ooh. Quilting.
Oh. Wow. Sounds like we need to start a show with you. Wow.
Square dancing, belly dancing.
And hula. You haven't suffered until you've had to go in your hula costume in January to perform somewhere.
January.
You are a hula dancer?
I was at one time.
Wow.
Try getting a grass skirt in Minnesota. It's hard.
What is happening? Fun. Who saw that coming?
I did not see that one coming, I'll admit. Fun fact, Daniel Boone, as you know, a famous American frontier explorer, he hated coonskin caps. He actually hated wearing them.
I don't blame him.
What do you hate to wear?
We have a buffalo robe down in the pioneer room.
Ugh.
That thing, not only does it smell,
it still
stinks terrible. It weighs like 75 pounds. I can't believe people wore them. I mean, I put it on one time and I think I lost about 3 inches and I can't afford to lose 3 inches. And I thought, okay, fold that back up. It's going back in storage.
So you hate to wear buffalo skin?
I hate to wear buffalo robes.
Sydney, this is a really important question. Do you know who received the first ever tattoo in Hastings?
I do not.
Well, we do.
We do.
Ooh,
well,
ooh.
I'll let you.
Well, Dan Massman, at the age, this guy right here, at the age of 12. Do you believe that? Quite a while ago. A long time ago.
Wow.
And in he's Hastings? Got that honor, though. Yeah.
In Kudos. Hastings?
In yeah. Hastings.
Now, was this a professionally done tattoo, or was this some behind the garage?
Knowing
tattoo?
Dan, definitely not.
Oh, okay.
Definitely not. I'm guessing that. All right, final question. True or false, Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure was the greatest piece of cinema to illustrate American history?
Oh, I'd have to say that's false.
Well, we're going to have to disagree on that, Cindy. All right, you made it through. Thank you very much.
Cindy, okay. You've been such a great sport. If people want to go to the Pioneer Room, tell us the hours, please.
We are open on Wednesdays from 9:30 until 4. We do occasionally, we'll come in if somebody's, you know, only going to be here one day and they're from out of state or something. We will certainly come in and help them. We just ask for a little notice ahead of time.
I love it. And a phone number?
Is 651-480-2367.
Wonderful. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Wow, we learned a lot about Hastings.
We did, didn't we?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I didn't even get to tell you about Harold Lyon, Hastings' own Indiana Jones.
Oh.
Well, you can't leave us on a teaser like that. All right, we're going to have Cindy part two talk to the town.
No, really, Harold Lyon is Hastings' Indiana Jones.
We had our own Indiana Jones, huh?
Yes, he went off to the wilds of Hawaii in the 1910s, and 1920s, to help them with the, they were having infestations. He's considered the father of Hawaiian agriculture. He helped them get rid of the pineapple blight and all sorts of things. We've got pictures of him out there, and he's in this costume with his hat, and he's hacking away with a machete. Oh yeah!
Did he have a whip? Did he have a whip too?
I didn't see that. I didn't see that. But
okay.
the Lyon Arboretum in Hastings is named after him.
Wow! And you're also looking for people, I know, to donate things.
Yes, we are a small museum, though. We can't take any John Deere tractors. I have lost count how many John Deere tractors we've been offered. We do have a scanner, so if you have historic photos, you do not have to give the photo to us. We just scan it and add it to our collection. We are also hoping people will come forward and tell us information about the early roads and the early stage lines. We are researching the stage lines and the stage coaches.
Okay.
Yep, yep. And also Hastings inventors. We've got over 50 inventors we've found from Hastings. And we're working on a book on women veterans from Hastings.
Wonderful. Wow, lots awesome. Going on.
Yep. Great.
Well, we have, thank you again, Cindy. And we'll have lots going on after this. We come back because we have another crock pot recipe.
You got that right.
What a crock.
What a crock.
Coming up. Welcome back. We are. We just talked about history, and we're about to make history with a historical recipe for what a crock.
There you go. Yes, what a crock. You know, Cindy didn't talk about the our Mexican or our friends in Hastings, but I didn't grow up on Mexican food, but Cinco de Mayo, we're celebrating that this month. Did you grow up on Mexican food?
I ate a lot of Taco Bell when through high school. Believe me, I know that menu very well.
Well, I think we're going to kick it up a notch here.
All right.
This is Mexican lasagna. Yes. Mm. So again, in the crock pot, easy. So your first thing, dear, would
Mexican
you
lasagna, yeah.
Yes. Would you be so kind as to spray this very liberally?
Okay,
we want to spray the bottom and the sides of our, that's not liberal enough. Oh Lord, really?
I could use a little, works for that too,
more,
right?
More, little friend,
it?
More friend. Thank
oh,
you.
Oh, more?
Yes. Oh my gosh.
Okay. I thought it was
right.
Shiny enough, but
you are shiny. You're shiny and new. All right, we're gonna put some. We're gonna layer. Thank you. Boop boop. We're gonna layer some.
What was that?
Boop, boop. Tortillas.
What was that
I was saying hello to our GoPro
oh,
camera.
Oh, this guy. Right
yes.
Here.
Okay, so we're gonna layer that. Be careful of your tie. So we're gonna just do some layering in our crock pot. So we're gonna take first we. Don't you love black beans? They're so good for you.
Really
now, those
good.
Will really give you shiny skin.
I always get black beans at Chipotle. Speaking of Mexican food, that's
okay, now be
place.
Careful. Now, that's ruined now. You can't use this anymore. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's how it works. Because right. You know why? Because I go home and actually our kids will watch a show later and they'll say, Mom, we ate that for dinner. I'll say,
true.
That's how it works. Yes. Okay.
Right.
So
for
we're
your
gonna,
kids' sake.
We're going to first take some... some diced tomatoes. We're gonna put some diced tomatoes down here.
All right.
Yes, and we're just layering things. So let's put some black beans. Okay, I think that's good for now. That's
oh.
good for now.
Well,
okay.
All right.
So let's take some black beans. We don't need quite that many. So we're gonna put some back in
oh.
here. And then we are gonna take some corn.
I think extra black beans are a nice
well,
touch.
Well, you
though.
Know what? We're layering those.
Holy
so we
cow.
Need to we
so
need to
do we just
save
need to
those.
Add looks
okay.
like we just need to put in like two black beans?
Exactly, just a few. So then we're gonna put some of this. And then we're gonna layer some corn. Now just
right.
a little bit. To
just a little bit.
Yep, just a little bit.
Just a little bit.
And then, yep, that's good, that's good. And then we're gonna put some, yep, perfect.
Right.
And then we're gonna put some, I diced up some onions, so we're gonna do that. Now
yummy.
We're gonna do more. Now you can put
oh,
some
put
of that.
Oh, put another tortilla down, another
yep,
layer?
Yep, put a couple of layers
oh,
of tortillas.
Oh, I see where you're going
we're
with this lasagna
thing.
We're
gonna put some Mexican, yep, see we're making lasagna. We're gonna put some Mexican cheese.
Yum.
Yum, and then we're gonna do it again, and we're gonna repeat our steps. So. Look at this.
Cool.
Isn't this fun? So now
it's like rinse, then
you kind of,
right?
yes, and I'm using my hands because, you know, there's no, we're kind of lacking, I would say, in true.
True what? We have everything we could ever ask for on this set.
We don't have everything. So we're putting some more seasoning. This is just taco seasoning. What else? You could put a few of those.
Is there some candy in that pinata? We can put that in there.
That actually
good.
would give it a little kick. Just a few, love. Just a few.
I like onions.
Remember?
Though.
Yeah, right. And that could be why you are lacking in dates. Mm-hmm. You just never know. Okay, and then we're gonna put some more corn.
She doesn't like onions. It wasn't meant to be.
And then we're going. Look at this. Isn't this gonna be pretty?
No.
So we're putting a layer of corn.
Very pretty.
And then we're gonna kick it off with some cheese, and then you can put another layer on.
I'm ready.
And you know what? Depending upon the size of your crock pot, I'm actually gonna put more cheese on than that. Depending upon the size of your crock
That's
pot.
What they call it, close up.
I know.
Boom.
You're ready for your close up. Okay, I was going to put
more cheese on. That was a good action shot right
there,
I bet.
Okay, so then I wonder if we should put another layer. I sort of feel we might be done.
I think that's good.
Yeah, I think we might be done. So I'm going to put some cheese on top, and maybe
Yum.
I'm going to put a couple of little.
You know, I think I'm going to follow you home tonight because this looks really good.
You
I'm
follow
gonna have to get
me home tonight as compared
but
to the other
nights.
But
this time I'm going to let you know that I'm following you, okay? I'm going to be a gentleman about it. I'm going to let you know that I'm following you home.
Right. You know what? I do have that restraining order against you when we're off.
Totally expired. Totally expired.
Did it, though?
You know that.
Did it, though? What else should we put? Let's put some more. Should we put some more salt? See, you know, the thing with this,
oh,
you
yeah,
can't
seasoning.
Go wrong.
Get more of that.
People say, are these real recipes when I run into people? Oh, you know what we forgot to do?
Salsa. Oh, man. Yeah, you're going to need salsa. Come on,
we
Mo.
Forgot
Come
salsa.
On. You're, Mo,
you
you're
know,
slipping.
Here's the thing about
She's
Mexican
slipping.
Food. You go and you order a burrito. You go, you order a taco. You go and you order
yeah.
a quesadilla. Pretty much all taste the same. So we're just going to whip this on top and hopefully, again, the thing about a crock pot, it's very forgiving. Don't you agree?
Oh, totally.
Yeah. All right, we're going to do this, and then we're going to plop the cover on.
Boom.
Boop. Now, we're going to cook this baby. I love how it almost went all the way up to the top. We're going to cook this baby about 4 hours on low.
Okay. Nice.
And then hopefully everything will smush down, especially the salsa, because we forgot to put layers of salsa. It is what it is. You can always add your own salsa at the end if you want to kick it up.
Nice. Mm-hmm. I'll tell you what, I need your help on this one, Mo.
Yes.
We're about to make history and do a quadruple What a Crock. Are you ready? Grab
yes.
two things.
Okay.
Here we go.
Here we go.
What a Crock. Look at that. Man.
And I need paper towel.
Yes.
Anyway, happy May, everybody. I think we can officially say that it's a kickoff of summer. Don't you
Definitely.
Agree?
Yes. Oh, for sure.
So this is a great easy thing for Cinco de Mayo or just for any time.
Definitely.
Yes. So thanks for watching. My
yes.
name is Mo.
And my name's Tom. And thank you to all those at Perkins that put up with us and for Cindy Thury-Smith for being our guest. That was awesome.
Exactly. And this show is called Talk
of the Town.
See you next time.